Hi guys, Phil Short here for Guitar Interactive magazine. We've got another review for you today and we're looking at the amazing Takamine GN90 CE acoustic guitar, electroacoustic guitar in fact, which is this beautiful specimen that I'm holding right here. And as you can see, it's gorgeous. It looks gorgeous, it sounds gorgeous. So let's quickly run through a few specs on this guitar. It's a solid spruce top, so solid top. And we've got a mahogany neck. And then the sides and the back are made from Zerikote, if I've pronounced that correctly, which is an alternative to rosewood. As many of you will know, rosewood is quite scarce to come by these days. And tonally, it's very similar sounding to that. We've also got this beautiful maple binding that goes all the way around the top and the back. And on the back of the guitar as well, you can see we've got a two-piece back and we've got this beautiful maple strip as well. And you can also see on the neck and the headstock, we've got this beautiful maple binding that goes all the way around the outside. We've got abalone dot inlays and we've got abalone for the rosette as well. We've also got these beautiful gold tuners as well with this open geared look, which kind of gives a really nice classic vintage styling to the guitar as well. And we've also got the inclusion of a strap nut on the underside here of the neck joint. So you won't be needing to get the old shoelace trick and tie a shoelace round here or go to a luthier or get your power drill out and risk damaging your guitar by adding one in. So that's a nice touch. Not everyone includes one of those. We've got standard fret markers on the sides, just black little dots there. So nice and clear in the maple binding, easy for you to see and locate where you are on the fingerboard. We've also got this fantastic built-in preamp as well. And this is Takamine's own design. And it's the TP40D version for those of you who are up to speed with Takamine's product range. And it's a really good natural organic sounding preamp. We've got this gain control, which essentially operates as a volume control. And then we've got bass, middle, and treble. And I'll demo these controls for you. Simple controls, but really powerful and really helpful for sculpting the kind of tone that you might require when you're using this on a gig. The guitar itself has a really amazing feel to it, actually. So if you're new to playing acoustic guitar and you're more of an electric player and used to playing with lighter strings and always find acoustics to be a little bit hard work, this guitar is amazingly well set up, especially for the price point that these guitars come in. Often you don't normally get a setup as good as on this one. The action is nice and low as well, and I think this one feels like it's got 11 to 49 gauge strings on it, so they're not too heavy either. Some thicker strings, maybe some 12 to 53s, if you've got stronger hands and you're used to playing those heavier strings, will give you a bit of a fuller sound. But as you heard, there's nothing lacking in the tone of the guitar at all, which is great. So really nice low fretboard action makes chording very, very easy. So those chords feel like no hard work whatsoever, which is fantastic. And it's so low, in fact, it really feels and performs like an electric guitar. Not that this is the instrument that you would do this with, but you could even if you were going to take a solo. Feels very easy to play all of our solos on. So if you were doing an acoustic trio set, or jamming acoustically with a piano player or something like that, or two of you on guitar, whatever the case may be, it was going to feel very easy to be able to take an instrumental solo at some point in the track, which is ideal. What else have we got to say about the guitar? Let's think about how the guitar sounds plugged in. So we've got this really wonderful and bright full sound, which is great, particularly for kind of pop styles of acoustic guitar. So this would work really well if you were playing in a band. It's going to cut through in the mix really nicely. The spruce top gives a real good brightness to it. So you can hear we've got this really good shimmering, sparkling top end that's not harsh in any way at all, just nice and brilliant. So that really kind of cut really well, sound great in a pop kind of context, which is really good. Now let's have a listen to this preamp. So let's say we wanted to just manipulate that sound. Of course, we can add bass, treble, and mid-range. One of the things that I find from gigging with acoustic guitars is boosting those frequencies can often cause feedback issues. So it's a better place, generally speaking, to start by cutting things. Now, if I remove the mid-range control on here, it's going to be more forgiving for my strumming technique as we hear more of the bottom end and the top end sparkle. I'm not going to hear too much kind of honky mid-range and clack. By contrast, if I boost that mid-range a little bit too much, a little bit honky for strumming, but you can hear that there's the guitar cuts through a little bit more. So one thing that's very useful tip that I like to do if I'm doing acoustic gigs is back off that mid-range control for the strumming and then just boost that mid-range control for single note lines. And then I can back it off again. So you can hear just by boosting a little bit of that mid-range, for any solo work that I might want to do on a gig, I can just fatten out the sound really nicely. Now let's have a little listen to the bass control. It's quite powerful, this bass control, so if I was playing on my own, I might want to boost that quite a bit. So it just adds a little bit more fullness to the sound, but if I was playing in a band mix, you know, I'd probably want to cut that back a little bit further. Okay, so we've heard the guitar plugged in DI'd, but let's have a listen to what it sounds like when it's mic'd up. So there you have it, guys, the Takamine GN90 CE. Go check one out.